Hi guys. Well, I was early to work this morning and late back tonight, so this is going to be a no-frills video. Then again, since when do I do any other type? Yeah, that's another subject for another discussion. If you've watched my previous videos and you've already clocked that I am stood right next to a monitor, you've probably worked out what's coming. It's one of these. It's a relatively nondescript box, so it's easy to get round the wrong way. It's a Microsoft Wireless Display Adapter 2. The 2 part is important. A number of people actually warned me to get the thing patched. It comes like this. A load of useless paperwork, which has just hit the floor. And one of these, which is a USB adapter. It's not much of an adapter as such. This is not a solid unit. There's a clear plastic bit in the middle, and what you have are 2 parts. One is USB, the other is HDMI. Because this USB is quite thick, what they do is they give you this adapter so you can convert the thick down to thin for some TVs. Hopefully this will work. I'm just going to do a little bit of messing around here. Just going to plug it in here to the HDMI. Oh, come on, don't give me any grief. The last thing I need today is grief. Yep, that goes in there like that, and this goes in the USB, which is around here somewhere. Do I have enough cable? Only just. Come on. There we go. That is now starting. The thingy, what's it, doodad. It's nice and bright and white, which is blowing out the camera. Yeah, I've got red flashing panic! All over the camera's LED display. It just can't handle that degree of white. It's booting. Oh, it's there. As you can probably notice, if you can actually read that, I've already logged on, patched it, and updated the name. I had to do that while I had access to a Windows 10 machine. Yeah, and that was fun in itself. Despite having a USB section to the adapter, you thought it would have been nothing to just download a firmware executable, plug it into a PC via the USB, and just flash the BIOS, or whatever it is that it's running. Oh no, that's far too easy. What I had to do was actually put this in a TV, fire it up, then I had to get the Windows 10 machine, create an account for Microsoft Store, App Store, in which it wanted to validate an email address, and it also wanted date of birth. Obviously I gave it false information. And after that, I had to use that to connect via Bluetooth and wireless to this. Then the app would allow me to change settings. The settings that I could change was, among other things, the name of the unit. And also there's a password protection if you wish to enable it, and a PIN protection if you wish to enable it. We did enable PIN protection on another one, and we even rebooted it. But after connecting with the device, it may have been because the device had already been connected. I don't know, maybe it's got a memory. It didn't ask for a PIN. Now this is Cyanogen. It's working on Miracast. Miracast is in Windows 10, definitely. Possibly Windows 8, maybe. Not Windows 7. And in order to update the firmware, you need the Apps Store access. So if you're running Windows 7, you're SOL. But Miracast has also been baked into Android. I'm not sure of the exact version numbers. check in the hoo-ha bar, because someone will probably tell. Now that I'm actually in here, I'm just going to take a look at the screen to see if there's anything that's going to betray me. I don't think so. And in here, I now have, in my settings, I have a cast button. So I'm going to hit cast. No devices enabled, available, so I'm just going to go into more settings and actually enable the wireless display. I normally keep it disabled, for obvious reasons. Now I'm going to select this display, and it should just connect. I hope. Yep, there you go. You can now see my mobile phone. I'm going to go into the gallery, and if I rotate it, you can then see that. So we have the gallery and all that good stuff. So you can instantly see some of the pictures that I've taken. You got full access to the phone, basically. Even this, which is video. And hopefully, you should hear audio on the TV.
Hi guys, here we go again. It's going to be another chat and play.
Or yep.
Mine and talk, or make a coherent sense about very delicate subjects.
Now this is 108.0 video. Just playing nicely on here. And coming up on there with sound.
I have no idea how far we'll have to go before we hit anything.
The resolution is quite nice. You've got audio, as expected. And basically, in terms of rendering, it's knocking the spots off the Chromecast, basically, is what it's doing. Absolutely knocking the spots off it. And that's 108.0 video. It costs about £35. You can get it for if you shop around. And I'm just going to disable casting. In fact, I'm going to turn the volume down. It can be used for a very cheap, if I go down there. More settings, disable. So that should hopefully save me some battery. Now, as you can probably work out by the one number, I actually got two. The difference is that these will get used, whereas the Chromecast has just been sat in its, it's just been sat there. But these will be used. I don't know, I don't think that Apple has a driver that will, or an application that will use Miracast yet. There's one been in production on Linux, fan production, for some time, for some years. The original developer, I think, basically gave up on it, and can I do that? Yes, I can do that. Doesn't look too good, but it allows me to at least keep it all in one chain. That go in there? Should do. Yes, it does. At least I can keep it all in one chain. It's nice and neat. Handy. And there's a reset button on the back. Didn't see that before. It's nice and black. Whereas I think on some versions it may be blue. I don't know. Handy, quick to deploy, quick to use, and it's useful in some cases because rather than getting a smart TV, you can save a lot of money, get a dumb TV, and use one of these. Working with Windows 10, Android, so if you're a business and you want to create some sort of a display in your meeting rooms and you don't want to spend too much money, this is an easy way to do it. For people who visit with Macs, you can easily just get an Apple TV and use that on the second HDMI channel in order for people with Macs to hook up. Linux, still going to be an issue, who knows, but as the majority of visitors that are going to be coming on site in the organizations that I've been in are Microsoft users anyway, it's a cheap and simple solution, which is also easy to deploy. I mean, as well as an organization having these, if you were the kind of person who does run around in different places and you happen to be carrying either a Chromebook or Windows 10 or possibly Windows 8 laptop, then carrying one of these around so you can quickly, easily connect to many of the modern TVs that are out there, heck, it's a no-brainer. For this kind of money, it's worthwhile just to be able to hook up to many HDMI TVs. With minimum fuss and just broadcast. The performance is said to be good at reasonable resolution, not quite up to gaming standard, but I don't think that dealing over Wi-Fi as they are, and I think Bluetooth for the administration connection, that's what I believe. You can't expect too much from a device at this kind of cost. So, yeah. Thank you very much for the few people who warned me to update the firmware. I did that. And when I powered the TV off, the display adapter, the WDA, shuts down as well. So there's no real threat of it being abused by someone. Because the minute the TV shut off, it shuts down as well. The one thing that I will say is that when you're actually using the software to program these, be mindful of the little blue dots that are vanishing underneath them. Sorry, if you change something like the name or the setting, those blue dots are actively communicating with this. When the blue dots stop, then it's written to the device and you're safe to unplug it. But for this kind of price, this kind of flexibility, yeah. Who knows how long these are going to be around for? And I'm going to get way more use out of these than I ever will with Chromecast. Put it that way. You see, some smart TVs can be a real pain. They can, in some cases, do way, way too much. And in other cases, the functionality between different smart TVs is different. And also, when they do automatic updates, the functionality can change. Something like this is more of a known constant. I really do wish that they would had enabled some sort of local flashing ability rather than having to hook these up to a sodding TV and go through all that faff. Ugh. You could view it as that's Microsoft's attempt to make sure that everybody's running Windows 10 and has given them their email information and blah 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 ya ya ya. But, yeah, given, I think they've actually shot themselves in the foot by that. Because it will potentially limit the number of people who will actually go out and buy these devices. If they'd made it more open, they could have dealt a serious blow to Chromecast with this. A very serious blow, I think. My throat is really gone. So, this is a very, very nice little device. On Windows 10 you just go into the Action Center or swipe down on your Android or Windows Mobile. Simple to operate. It doesn't take that long. Once you get around the faffery of actually getting on the App Store and getting the application in the first place, it doesn't take that much faffery. I had a couple of failed connections. Just had to wait for it to settle and then reconnect, and then I was able to talk to it again with the software. But yeah. Can't really go wrong. Nice little unit. We'll see how long they last for. But with Miracast being cross-platform, I can see it knocking an awful lot of other solutions in the marketplace on the head, simply because it is going to be so widely usable, easy to use, flexible. There's a little bit of security on there as well, and pretty much nearly device agnostic. As long as you've got a reasonable version of Windows or Android. It's going to be interesting to see whether this product actually kickstarts Linux development, because I think that Ubuntu may have also picked up on the project. And that actually reminds me why I got the Ubuntu phone out, because I wanted to update it, because there was chatter about Ubuntu actually putting Miracast on the phone as well. But I never actually got around to updating the phone. Such is life. See you on the next video. Bye for now. And by the way, this is the Windows Wireless Display Adapter. Sorry, the Microsoft Wireless Display Adapter version 2. That's important. If you don't have Windows 10, it is possible to use it out of the box, because it does just give you a generic name. But there's no security on it. And as people have said, there are issues with the firmware. Yeah. Bye for now.